Did you know that Ukraine has this new symbol, which is a white cross, and they put it on their military vehicles? But what's even more important is that Ukraine was able to liberate 700 square kilometers and 50 settlements in Kharkiv region. In addition to that, we have this upcoming battle for Kupyansk, which can potentially change everything. And today I will explain why. And finally, the second fun fact for today is that one of the biggest weapon sponsors for Ukraine is Russia. But more about all of this in just a couple of minutes. What's up, investors? It's the Russian dude. And let's go straight to the point and talk about this literally unstoppable counteroffensive of Ukraine in the east. As you can see from this video, this is one of the last street fights for the city of Balakliya. And as you can see from this map, Ukraine was able to fully liberate this city and the majority of its neighboring regions. We then have this video, which President Zelensky posted himself, and these are basically Ukrainian soldiers declaring the full victory and liberation of Balakliya. But okay, then we go to this small city of Borshivka, and from this video we can see that this town was also liberated. Moving a little bit to the north, we have this picture which came to us from Shevchenkove, which basically lets me assume that this town was also liberated, and now it opens even further directions for Ukrainians. And because of this, Russians have to retreat and abandon the majority of their military equipment and vehicles. And as you can see from this video, which also came to us from Balakliya, Ukrainians take these weapons to themselves. Which basically makes Russia to be one of the biggest donors of weapons to Ukraine. In several seconds I'll talk about the upcoming battle for Kupyansk, which most likely is going to be major turning point battle in the east, but first of all, just a couple of words about the events leading to this battle. First of all, even though the map does not reflect this yet, according to both Ukrainian and Russian sources, the army of Ukraine is only a couple kilometers away from Kupyansk. Second, we have this statement by the Russian commander Apty Alaudinov that they gave up Balakliya deliberately. And what they mean by that is that they are trying to capture Ukrainians and fight against them where it's favorable for Russians. But I mean, come on, I think in just a couple of days we'll hear about the giving up of Balakliya as a gesture of goodwill. But okay, finally we have this video by Russian infiltrators in Kupyansk region that they need to evacuate local residents, especially women and children, as soon as possible. And even though it seems like Russian infiltrators had only good intentions in their minds to save the lives of local residents, so far the only ones who evacuated from Kupyansk to Vovchansk are the Russian infiltrators themselves. And to sum it all up, according to the Brigadier General of Ukrainian army, Alexei Gromov, in just several days, Ukraine was able to liberate more than 700 square kilometers of land in Kharkiv region. In addition to that, it is also estimated that approximately 20 settlements have been liberated. And I mean, like, come on, just think about it, 700 kilometers in less than a week. Just wait a second, let me put my iPad down. Good job, Ukraine. But the good news do not end here. And now, as promised, let's talk about potentially the major battle of the East, which is the battle for Kupyansk. And while I'm going there, please consider liking this video and subscribing to my channel if you like this style of daily updating. Alright, so one of the biggest importance of this city for Russians is that it is located in the intersection of major railroads. And as you can see from these white lines, Russians were using these railroads to resupply basically everywhere across the east of Ukraine. And I mean, you probably already guess where I'm going with this. First of all, if Ukrainians are able to recapture Kupyansk, and most likely they will be able to do it, this immediately disrupts the logistics of Russians in the east. It will then become so much harder to resupply the north and the south, which includes such key cities as Severodonetsk, Lysychansk, Izum and Kharkiv. In addition to that, several reports claim that there are already individual Ukrainian groups which are located just 20 kilometers to the south of Kupyansk in the cities of Sinkeve and Sinkhove. Which means that besides attacking from the west, they will be also able to attack from the south. And finally, if Ukrainians are able to break through and split the Russian army in two, this will most certainly give them a significant advantage. And I mean, just think about it. The logistics is disrupted, the morale is low, and the Ukrainian counteroffensive is unstoppable. We will be most likely looking at full liberation of Kharkiv region and the majority of the east to the south of this territory. Alright, and before we talk about pretty much the same extremely successful counteroffensive of Ukrainians in the south, allow me to just quickly show you several more footages from the east. First of all, as you can see from this video, a Ukrainian self-propelled artillery is attacking Russian positions next to Izum. Then we also have this picture from Kharkiv, which shows us the result of Russian shelling of the city. But then we have this video from Belgorod, where an electrical equipment has been damaged and left the city without electricity. Then, as we go a little bit more to the south, we have this video from Vasilievka. And as you can see, a local checkpoint was blown up, but Ukrainians said that they were not attacking this place, which probably means once again somebody was smoking. And finally, potentially another Russian military warehouse in Tokmak was destroyed by Ukrainians. And by the way, if you want to see way more footage like this, especially the one which I was not able to use in today's episode, please consider checking my Patreon. All the proceeds will be donated to Ukraine, and you can find all the useful links down below. Alright, and now as promised, let's quickly talk about even more good news from the south. And as you can see from this picture which came to us from Vysokopolye, this city is now completely liberated by Ukrainians. Then we have this video from Kherson region, which shows us the ongoing counteroffensive of Ukraine. Right now, the majority of efforts are concentrated in the east, but Ukraine still does a lot of progress in the south. It has even been reported that Ukrainians were able to breach another line of defense of Russians in Posad Pokrovskaya. And the head of Mykolaiv region, Vitaly Kim himself, he said, "Please expect very good news tomorrow." At this point, both the south and the east are incredibly successful for Ukraine. So just please let me know in the comments which one of these regions you think will be liberated first. And before we move into ridiculous Russian propaganda, believe it or not, here is one more good news. It is that recently the US approved another $675 million support assistance package to Ukraine. And this package will include missiles for HIMARS, 1.5 million rounds of ammunition, 100 armored personnel carriers, 1,000 mines, and much more. Bring it home, Ukraine, and bring it strong. Welcome to another episode of Ridiculous Russian Propaganda. And today we have this video from Russian gas company Gazprom, and this is basically about cutting the supplies of gas to Europe and creating another ice age. As you might have guessed, the video is basically showing all these frozen European cities. And the main message of this propaganda is to say that Gazprom is the only Russian company that keeps the entire Europe alive. And basically, yeah, you decided to go against Russia, enjoy your very last winter. And one quick thing, I want to personally say thank you to Steve Davidson, Don Pam Harley, Rudolf De Heer, Artu Harmala, the GoPro MTB, Mark Whitford, and Kurlindert Handy for becoming my most recent channel members. And if you want to support my work and unlock some benefits, please consider becoming my channel member as well. And yeah, if you want to see the full video of Ridiculous Russian Propaganda, feel free to join my Discord. Yes, it's completely free. Thank you so much for your attention, stay safe, and see you tomorrow.